Climate change is this big, scary thing that's going to crush us if we're not careful. On a technical level, it means that our activities and the way we live are changing the climate around us in a way that is not just bad for the plants and animals, but it's actually bad for us.
Since the beginning of the Industrial Revolution, we have been, for instance, burning fossil-based fuels. These fossil-based fuels drive CO2 into the atmosphere, and this causes a warming pattern in our climate. And as a result, we're also having other extreme weather patterns that can give rise to issues related to, for instance, food production, as well as clean water access and things like that.
It will cause droughts. There will be food shortages. It's causing dislocation of people. Climate change affects all of us, and we all have to be involved in dealing with it.
It's a big opportunity for us to come together and make a better world. Stopping deforestation, stopping wasting food, thinking about ways to improve our transportation systems. And then there are others that should involve things like removing carbon from the atmosphere or even developing new technologies to replace some of the ones that we have today.
STEM is absolutely critical if we're going to deal with climate change, because almost every issue with respect to climate change is a technical issue, is going to require people developing better technologies and figuring out how to get them to scale quickly.
Carbon removal is the idea of cleaning up some of the greenhouse gas mess that we've created that's driving climate change. The interesting thing is there's so many ways to do this. We can use plants to do this, like regenerative agriculture, literally tilling our fields differently. We can use naturally occurring minerals. We can use marine ecosystems, literally regenerating whale populations or kelp or plants. It's not one thing, but the net result is taking CO2 molecules out of the air and disposing them somewhere else.
The reason that we focus on carbon is because about 76% of these greenhouse gases actually are carbon dioxide.
When I think about climate solutions or carbon removal, it's naturally a long-term thing, and it's going to take us some time to get out of this hole. So we're already thinking not just what we do this year, but what we do 5, 10, 15 years in the future. In young people, youth, young leaders, we actually have to bring them into the conversation.
The point of First Global is to show all kids around the world that they're dealing with the same issues, that the common language of mathematics and the common laws of physics are the same for everybody everywhere. So we need the next generation of young, enthusiastic people with energy and courage and imagination jumping in as soon as possible so that all of them can conquer this problem of global climate change.
Even though you're working on a robotics challenge, all those skills, the personal skills, the technical skills, the organizing skills, that's exactly what we need for the climate crisis, for engaging governments, for engaging policymakers, building companies, supporting companies, or just working in your community. The skills you're developing now will stay with you and are very relevant to working on climate solutions too.
You're all powerful and you can single-handedly change the world. However, in order to do that, you have to believe it. So go out, understand what your own carbon footprint is, learn and educate yourselves so that you can then begin educating others.
And remember that the most important thing that's happening is you're building the skill sets and you're building the community that we hope over your life and your career will make you part of the army of people that help solve the world's problems.